The farther you go in sin, the more seared your conscience gets, and the harder it becomes to see what the truth is. Many Christians have been given over to a strong delusion because their consciences are seared, and even though they know the truth of God, they don't see Him clearly. I want to read to you from 2 Thessalonians chapter 2, starting in verse 9. The coming of the lawless one is according to the working of Satan, with all power, signs, and lying wonders, and with all unrighteous deception among those who perish because they did not receive the love of the truth that they might be saved. And for this reason, God will send them strong delusion, that they should believe the lie, that they all may be condemned who did not believe the truth, but had pleasure in unrighteousness. The farther you go in sin, thinking that you're with God because you're going to church, because you've prayed a prayer or you read the Bible, the more invested you will be in this lie, in this delusion. There are some Christians that are so incredibly involved in the lie, they don't even know that they're in the lie. They're so involved and so dedicated that they can't give up their life to be reborn because they've invested too much in the lie. Turn while you can. Turn while you still have time. Turn from sin, from doubting, and all these lies that will sear your conscience and your heart in sin. The closer you are to those who sin, the more likely you'll be able to justify sin in your own heart. You will think so-and-so does this and they turned out okay. They must be okay with God. I'm sure they pray. I'm sure they're right with the Lord. You will start to justify all sorts of things. Stay separate from sinners and those who cause you to sin. Don't let your conscience be seared, but walk with Jesus in total righteousness and holiness. If you start going with Him, you'll be on the right path. But if you start hanging out with people who cause you to sin, and you start to justify a little bit of sin, suddenly you'll be going down this path, and God will send you a strong delusion. The path of unrighteousness, the path of dead religion, the path where you don't really see the glory of God, but you just see the arm of the flesh at work. I encourage you to really go with Jesus. Separate yourself from anything and anyone that causes you to fall into sin or to fall to lukewarmness. May the grace of Jesus be with you.